Today, I am pleased to announce that thanks to your efforts, we are proceeding with stage one of Alberta's relaunch strategy. On the advice of our public health officials, we will be taking a gradual regional approach to reopening for certain activities that require greater physical proximity. Dr. Hinshaw has flagged two specific areas, Calgary and Brooks, where we continue to see a disproportionate number of cases. Together, they account for three-quarters of our current cases of COVID-19 and hospitalizations. As such, we've accepted the Chief Medical Officer's advice to have a slightly slower, phased relaunch in those two communities. This is consistent with the regional approach that we said might be required when we first announced our relaunch plan a couple of weeks ago. So starting tomorrow, a wide array of businesses and facilities will be able to reopen in most of Alberta, including retail businesses like clothing, furniture and bookstores, along with all vendors at farmers markets, hairstyling and barbershops, museums and art galleries, more scheduled surgeries, dental procedures, physiotherapy, chiropractic, optometry and similar services, and daycares and out-of-school care and day camps, including summer school, with limits on occupancy. Restaurants, cafes, pubs, and bars with seating at 50% of their legal capacity. Post-secondary institutions will have more flexibility for course delivery, including in-person or in combination with online learning. And places of worship may reopen their doors, including for funerals, under strict guidelines. The lifting of these restrictions is in addition to those announced at the beginning of the month, which included the reopening of golf courses, boat launches, and private and municipal parks, sports fields, outdoor courts, as well as playgrounds, and the resumption of scheduled non-urgent surgeries, along with services provided by some regulated health professions as long as they follow approved guidelines from their professional colleges, like the dentists. And the reopening of provincial campgrounds with some restrictions, including for overnight camping at some parks starting June the 1st and most others by June the 15th. It's an evolving process that will change as we learn more about the virus and about what can be done relatively safely and under what conditions. I want to remind Albertans that our province has remained far more open than other provinces and most other jurisdictions around the world. In fact, 85% of Alberta businesses, representing 96% of our province's economy and 88% of our workforce, have been allowed to stay open over the past 2 months. On top of that, we're moving more quickly to reopen before other jurisdictions, and we are doing so prudently to reduce the chance of a second spike that could force an even more damaging set of public health restrictions.
With respect to relaunch, I would like to echo the Premier in thanking Albertans for their commitment to protecting one another. Thank you for the sacrifices that you have made, ones that only a few short weeks ago would have seemed unimaginable. Make no mistake, there have been sacrifices. Lives, lifestyles, and livelihoods have all been impacted. We've been physically distanced from those we love and care about, and I know how difficult it has been. We've missed birthday gatherings, postponed weddings, and celebrations of life. And Albertans have responded to this unprecedented challenge with compassion and grace. They've found ways to connect with each other, to help one another, and to thank one another, with a particular focus on thanking those on the front lines. I know the last few weeks and few months feel like we have traveled a long and arduous road together. While our journey is far from over, I hope we can take a moment today to recognize what we have collectively achieved. We often think that one person's actions can't make a difference, but by following public health guidance, practicing physical distancing, washing our hands regularly, and staying home when sick, every single one of us has helped to save lives. Albertans should feel incredibly proud for looking out for one another and helping us to collectively move forward with this relaunch. As we move into stage one, I know that many are experiencing mixed emotions: relief, excitement, anger, anxiety, and fear. But I want to assure you that protecting Albertans' health and well-being is at the forefront of every decision that is made. We would not jeopardize all that you have risked and sacrificed by beginning to reopen prematurely. I feel confident that it is the right time to move into stage one. That being said, stage one allows businesses to open at the discretion of owners and operators. There is no directive to say they must open on a particular day. If an owner determines they need additional time to put appropriate measures in place to protect staff and patrons, I encourage Albertans to be supportive and not critical. These are difficult decisions that are being made to protect you and those around you. As I've said before, once businesses reopen, we want Alberta to stay open. And we want businesses to be successful and Albertans to stay safe.